In 2012, the Walt Disney Company purchased the rights to Lucasfilm for a total of $4 billion. The acquisition gave them the rights to both Star Wars and the Indiana Jones film series. This was in addition to acquiring Marvel Comics back in 2009 for another reported $4 billion in cash. Many wondered what they would do with the property. It wasn't long after that we got the news that Disney would be making a new series of Star Wars films, along with spin-off films featuring a young Han Solo, Rogue One, and fan favorite Boba Fett. On December 15, 2015, the first film under Disney's stewardship, Star Wars The Force Awakens, landed in cinemas. With the success of their other studios, Marvel and Pixar, there are some who seem to be actively rooting for something by Disney to fail. And much like in the case of Ant-Man and Guardians of the Galaxy, I am very happy to disappoint them. Star Wars The Force Awakens is not just good, it's damn good. Set 30 years after the events in Return of the Jedi, Star Wars The Force Awakens finds that the galaxy is once again in a state of civil war. A new evil has risen from the remnants of the Empire, and once again the Jedi have fallen into the realm of myth and legend. Luke Skywalker has vanished into self-imposed exile after attempting to train a new Jedi Order, only to have his efforts destroyed by one student who has turned to the dark side. A droid carrying a map leading to Skywalker falls into the hands of a young scavenger on the desert planet of Jakku named Rey. Rey then must deliver the droid to the new rebel forces known as the Resistance before they are destroyed by the new ultimate weapon, the Starkiller. If these plot points seem familiar, they should, as they are lifted directly from the 1977 film. Yet, unlike the prequels, they don't slavishly handcuff themselves to a roadmap where we know what the eventual outcome will be. Director J.J. Abrams strikes the right balance between new and old, and passes the torch to a new generation of heroes while revisiting the original cast that made the series so popular. Even though the story follows many of the familiar story beats from the original 1977 film, this is not merely a retread of that movie, as it never once feels like it's handcuffed to those plot points. Sure, there are things that are familiar, such as X-Wings, TIE Fighters, a desert planet which is home to a remote outpost, and a villain in a black robe and mask. However, there's a good reason for all those things being in the film, and that reason is because it's a Star Wars movie. Abrams, along with screenwriters Michael Arndt and Empire Strikes Back scribe Lawrence Kasdan, is as always profoundly adept at pacing a movie. Big set pieces are often followed by brief respites to allow the audience to digest what they've just seen. The dialogue never gets too bogged down with tedious exposition, which was a major problem in previous films. Yes, there are some plot holes that aren't explained, such as, we don't know much about the First Order beyond they're evil, and they've risen from the ashes of the Empire. However, there's a good reason for that, and it's because there's going to be two more movies. The characters and the story itself are moving forward, as is the entire universe. Even though the original cast does return, they don't appear until well into the second act, and their roles are more supporting the newcomers rather than just to provide merely fan service. The look of the film is absolutely massive. Huge, sweeping vistas give the film an enormous sense of scale. The costumes and character designs by Michael Kaplan give you the sense that this is a living, breathing universe, and not just sets, costumes, and CGI. While everything is recognizable, it also has the feeling that it evolved naturally. Daisy Ridley plays the young scavenger Ray from the planet Jakku, who brings out a toughness in the character, but yet at the same time is very endearing. John Boyega, who plays the reluctant hero Finn, is terrific. Adam Driver as Kylo Ren, the consummate yet conflicted villain, never descends into being a one-dimensional caricature. The one character you feel like you want to know more about is Lupita Nyong'o's Maz Kanata, yet if she had more screen time, then the character would risk overstaying her welcome. Gwendolyn Christie as Captain Phasma is a great character with an iconic look who does not get a lot of screen time and almost feels like a merchandising opportunity. Wait a minute, that reminds me of somebody. Harrison Ford and Carrie Fisher both return as Han Solo and Princess Leia Organa, but don't appear until well into the second act, and are both now in more maternal and paternal roles.
Thanks, Freddy, foreshadowing.
With Solo having returned to smuggling, and with Leia as the new leader of the rebel forces known as the Resistance. But one of the best performances is from Domhnall Gleeson as the First Order General Hux. General Hux may be a one-note character, but Gleeson plays it magnificently to the hilt. Andy Serkis plays the mysterious Snoke, who we'll probably learn more about in the next movie. And Oscar Isaacs as Poe Dameron? What more can you say, really? Star Wars The Force Awakens is an outstanding entry into the series. It's the type of movie that you used to look forward to back when you were a kid, before summer blockbusters started taking themselves far too seriously and became brooding self-parodies. It's a fun film that, much like its predecessors, comes along at a time when that's exactly what was needed. It's a great feeling to once again hear those familiar crescendos and have a genuinely chill-inducing moment that will give you that feeling every time you see it again and again. J.J. Abrams, Lawrence Kasdan, Michael Arndt, the cast, and everyone associated with this film have done a magnificent job. Star Wars The Force Awakens gets a solid 5 out of 6 Chewbaccas. Star Wars is back, and it's back in a big way. That's it for now. See you next time.
The Force. It's calling to you. Just let it in.
Best-selling show. Is there life on Mars?